In this video, we will give you top 10 tips for DBT biotech entrance examination, plus all the important topics, as well as a list of standard books, standard reference books, which you should refer for DBT BET exam. And we are starting right now. For starters, DBT biotech entrance exam is conducted somewhere in the month of April every year. And if you wish to stay up to date about its notifications, then be sure to subscribe to Biotechnica, your one-stop solution to all the entrance examinations, job alerts, admission alerts, and in short, anything and everything from the biotech and pharma industry. The link to subscribe is given in the description. Now, let's get started with the topic of the day, and that is the DBT Biotech Entrance Exam and its top 10 tips, which will help you qualify faster, easier, and with lesser effort. So, tip number one, or let's say the first tip of the day, is know syllabus hacks and exam pattern hacks well. Now, this is pretty obvious. You need to know the latest exam pattern of the DBT exam. Now, for example, many sections are there in this question paper, how many sections are there and how many questions you can attempt from each section, etc. You should know the syllabus, you should know which is the important topic, you should be able to identify by just looking at the syllabus which units you should prepare and which one you should skip, and then only you should start preparing. Now, to make your life easy, I have included a free ebook to find the answers to all these questions. So be sure to check out the link given in the description below, and you will be able to download a PDF ebook which will help you answer all these questions. Number two, start preparing early and effectively. Now, prepare at least 6 months before the DBT JRF exam date, so that you will be having ample amount of time to cover the entire syllabus. You can prepare on your own, but for competitive exams like DBT JRF, joining reputed coaching companies such as Biotechnica will definitely help you study the right way. One of the best ways to prepare effectively is to identify the important topics. Now, you should also make notes using the Cornell method. You should revise using the spaced repetition method and practice as much questions as possible from the DBT JRF test series, as well as previous year question papers of the DBT BET exam. Number three, adopt smart study methodology. Now, under this point, I would like to highlight a few important methods which we suggest to adopt to all our students at Biotechnica. Now, the first is, start the preparation with easy topic first. Okay, don't try to touch the jumbo topic. Second, focus on important topics. Third, always select two units, one easy, one hard, for the preparation together, so that you, if you have less time, you can go hand in hand. Fourth, assign day slots for units in a week, assign hour slots for subunits in a day. Now, the fifth and last point under this would be, don't forget to revise previous topics before starting a new topic. You follow the spaced repetition method. And sixth would be, minimum 5 to 6 study hours is required every day compulsorily if you wish to qualify this exam. So these are the 6 pointers under the smart study methodology. Now, let's move on to the next tip, which is tip number 4. Number 4, prepare well for Part A. Now, Part A contains 50 compulsory questions. At this juncture, for this section, all you need is basic knowledge. Your last 2 to 3 years of your degree course, like BTech or MSc syllabus, that should be sufficient for that. Now, here also focus on basic concepts of biochemistry, such as macromolecule, such as the structure of macromolecules, the enzymes and enzyme kinetics, enzyme metabolism, numerical concepts, Similarly, you should also focus on the basic concepts of biotechnology, such as recombinant DNA technology, tissue culture, cloning, basics of genetics, cell biology, such as cell signaling, cell cycle, cancer, protein sorting, membranes, organelles, basics of immunology, such as antibody structure, techniques, microbiology techniques, such as growth kinetics, microscopy, etc. Now, it is advised to prepare all these topics from an MCQ point of view, especially for theoretical topics like genomics and proteomics, safety and bioethics. All these topics you have to prepare well. Number 5, how to select topics for Part B preparation. Now, Part B, under Part B, you should choose at least 4 to 5 interconnected areas in which 50 out of 150 questions should be attempted from your specialized field. Now, since these questions are from 10 different subjects, so if you prepare for one subject, it's not going to help. Okay, specific subject is risky. So it is suggested that you select one subject, which is your core subject, on the basis of your previous knowledge from your graduation or your post-graduation course. However, also take up one more subject, okay, as per your comfort level. The syllabus is very diverse. So try selecting the topics that cover at least 40% of the entire syllabus. That's the mantra here. Number 6, make short but smart notes. Now, you can make short notes using the Cornell method or in form of flowcharts. That's the best way of making notes. You can also prepare flashcards or tables, etc. This will help you in your quick revision process. Separate short and brief notes can be maintained for all the topics, all the important experimental questions, concepts, formula, and constants. All this you have to keep revising. You have to keep revising on the go. So make notes properly. Highlight important points like definitions, equations, units, laws, etc. Always jot down working principles and formulas as well, and always memorize on the go. Number 7, do spaced repetition revision. Now, do frequent revision of topics you have studied using the spaced repetition method. Now, this will help you remember facts and figures, topics that you have covered, and also it will help you boost your confidence. So to help you revise faster as well as smarter, Biotechnica offers DBT BET Revisor self-learning course for all the DBT JRF aspirants to assist you in your exam preparation. So if you are looking for that, you can always check the description below. Remember, if you want success in this exam, then studying more or studying everything is not required. But a regular revision of the topics that you have studied is the key to success. Now, we have made a separate video on spaced repetition already. So check the description below and know more about spaced revision, spaced repetition, which will help you understand and fast forward your preparation. Number 8, train your brain, practice and perform. Now, first create exam-like conditions at your home, and then solve previous year question papers and give mock test in a fixed time format. Go through all the questions, all the previous year DBT-JRF question papers to understand the kind of questions asked in the DBT-JRF exam, and understand what you should prepare and what you should leave. You have to keep honing the previously practiced topics and solve as many mock test papers as possible. Whenever you pick a question paper, remember to first attempt the most scoring questions in which you are super confident. Number 9, remember to refer good reference books for preparation. In today's era, there are multiple sources of information available. But as an aspirant, you must rely only on valid reference sources and not just on any random tutorial which exists on internet. Remember, you need to clear your concepts with the help of good books and updated study materials only to avoid facing any kind of hurdles or confusions or silly mistakes during the exam. DBT-JRF questions are framed to bring out your understanding and basic knowledge of life sciences. Hence, preparation must be concise, crisp, and precise. You should be precise over the concepts and the basics of the concepts. Avoid random preparation. Trying to cover everything in the syllabus is a strict no-no. And running on the path of blind learning, never. Also, do not study any new topic in the last few days of the exam. Remember to keep the last few days only for revision. Number 10, keep yourself up to date, use advanced preparation tools, and stay away from distractions. Subscribe to Biotechnica's daily newsletter so that you can get latest updates about the DBT BET exam right in your inbox. And now you can also download Biotechnica's official app for DBT exam preparation. You can prepare well, prepare better, and keep shining in your career always. At Biotechnica, we wish to tell you this very important thing, that without your efforts, you cannot succeed. We are just a catalyst. Thank you so much for watching this video. We'll see you soon in the next one. Bye-bye.